everyone is talking about artificial intelligence taking people's job and replacing them, and I don't agree. Artificial intelligence will not take your job. A person using artificial intelligence will. Today, it will be foolish to ignore tools like ChatGPT. If you write software for a living, ChatGPT can 10x your productivity overnight. So I want to show you in this video 10 different ideas I personally use to increase the amount of value I can deliver every single day with a fraction of the time. I'm not gonna go into details about what ChatGPT is and how it works internally, but if you've never used it before, you can go to chat.openai.com, sign up for an account, and you'll be ready to go. This is the interface we are going to use. If you need to ask a question, you will type it here. If it's about code, you can go grab that code, paste it here, and that's it. So let me show you how I use this, starting with the idea number one, which is taking a piece of code that might be complex and asking ChatGPT to explain it back to me. So for example, I have here a function. It's a specific Python function that connects to an API, and I'm gonna ask ChatGPT explain this function. And I'm gonna send that request, and ChatGPT will write a description of what that function is doing. Notice that this is extremely powerful whenever you're dealing with code that you didn't write yourself or might be too complex to understand. The first step, instead of spending 10 minutes trying to figure out how it works, you can just come here and ChatGPT will give you a full description of that. Here's the explanation. It goes over every single argument of that function, what's doing, the libraries that's using. This is really, really amazing. The second idea is that you can use ChatGPT to extend, to modify a piece of code. For example, in this function, I'm connecting to a remote API, but I'm not handling any errors. So one thing that I could do is ask ChatGPT, hey, I want to raise an exception if the authentication that I'm using to connect to that API is incorrect. So I can send that, and ChatGPT will modify my function to return a new function that handles that specific exception. Notice here that ChatGPT is telling me the way it's handling the exception is by checking that the status code is not 200, but we can even be more specific. So we can tell it modify the code to raise an exception if we get an authorization error. Through prompting, I can guide ChatGPT to do exactly what I want to get out of the code. So in this case, hopefully ChatGPT will specifically tackle the 401 error code, which is the one related to an authorization error. So let's see if that's the case. Yeah, so now instead of checking if the response is not 200, now ChatGPT is actually targeting 401. Now, I understand that you could also do that in your source code. You don't need ChatGPT to do that for you. But this is just to illustrate how through prompting, you can be guiding ChatGPT to modify the code, to extend it, to add additional functionality that you might need, and how it's gonna do that for you. Third idea, you can use it to rewrite your code in a more idiomatic way, or maybe following the correct naming convention. So this is very helpful if you have somebody on your team, for example, that comes from a different programming language. So you can take their code, or they can use ChatGPT to improve on that, right? To rewrite that code using more Pythonic constructs, right? So in this particular case, I have an example here, which is the same function that we saw before, but now I rewrote that function in a way that is not following Python's naming convention. So you can see here how I'm using capital letters for the arguments as well. For these variables, response JSON is capitalized. So I'm telling ChatGPT, hey, rewrite this function following Python naming conventions. I'm gonna submit that. And now ChatGPT is gonna return the same function following the correct style, right? It's gonna save a ton of work for people that have to do this or want to learn how to write more Pythonic code or whatever language you're currently using. Notice here how ChatGPT renamed all of the variables, the function name, response JSON, it includes that underscore, which is, you know, Very, very accurate in this case. The fourth idea is one of the most powerful ones. I already showed you how you can take a piece of code that's too complex and ask ChatGPT to explain it back to you. Instead of doing that, you can also paste here some code and ask ChatGPT to simplify that code, and that's extremely powerful. For example, here I have just a fragment of code that I copied from an online website, and basically this is three variables and it's trying to determine which one is the largest variable. So I can go and ask ChatGPT, simplify the following code. Let's do Python code. And just to make it simpler, I'm just gonna put this inside those quotes so it knows what the code is. I'm gonna submit this and let's see what ChatGPT does. It says, here is a simplified version of the code. Getting rid of all of the parentheses, that is true. We don't need all of those parentheses in Python. And now this is way, way cleaner. It's explaining now how it simplified the code. It's telling me which conditions are not necessary. Something to keep in mind is I am not checking this code right now, so there might be a bug in this code. We don't know. We always need to make sure we verify what ChatGPT is telling us, but this is a great start. It's taking a piece of code that's very complex. It's simplifying that piece of code for us. So the next step, which is the next idea that we can try, is let's ask ChatGPT to basically write test cases for us. So I can ask it, write a few test cases to test the above functionality. And this is one or another one of the most powerful ideas on how to use ChatGPT. We basically tell it, hey, I want to test this functionality. And it's gonna give us a few examples of how to do that. So we can literally take all of that code and use it together with the simplified version of the functionality to test whether it's working or not. Another idea is if you are working on a code base that doesn't have test cases, you can also use these to start writing those test cases and making sure your functionality is working fine. So here it gave me 5 different test cases. And you can see how the first one, you know, is trying 10, 20, and 30, and the output should be 30. And here is telling me, you know, 3 negative numbers and the output is supposed to be a negative 10. When everything is 0, it's supposed to return 0. When everything is 100, it's supposed to return 100. And in this case, it's supposed to return 200. So that is an amazing way to use ChatGPT to just extend your code base using test cases as well. The sixth idea is to use ChatGPT to explore different alternative ways to write a piece of code. For example, I've used it to optimize my code. Hey, this is functionality, this is what it does. Can you give me a more optimal way of writing that code? Which is a very, very cool way. I'm gonna try it out with this same function that we have here to see what happens. So I can ask it, write an alternative version of the largest function. I can ask that. It knows exactly what the largest function is because we've been working with it, so it keeps that context. And it's just gonna give me an alternative way of writing that function. The most important part here is that this is going to give you ideas of what you're doing right, what you're doing wrong. You can explore different variants. You can ask it for different ways of writing that function. And it's a great way to discover, for example, that one solution could be using the max functionality. And that's an alternative way that you can keep exploring in your code to improve that. The seventh way we can use ChatGPT is to translate code from one programming language to another programming language. For example, here, this is code that I found online. It's a function that finds an element inside an array. It's written in JavaScript. So I'm gonna ask ChatGPT to translate the function from JavaScript to Python. And here ChatGPT is just gonna give me exactly the same function back, but now written in Python. This is very helpful. For example, if you have functionality running on your client side that you want to move in the backend, so maybe your client was developed using JavaScript and now you want to translate that into Python, or if you want to port an old code based into a new programming language, ChatGPT will be really good for that. So here is the implementation now using Python, and you can see the ChatGPT gave me an explanation of everything that happened there. We can move to the next idea, which I really love, and I'm gonna ask ChatGPT to write documentation for this function. And if you read documentation before, you know it, it's really painful, at least for me it is. Now ChatGPT is going to analyze that function and write the entire documentation of that function. And that saves a ton of time. Now, obviously I'm gonna have to go and check and make sure the documentation is accurate, but this starting point is amazing and it's gonna save me a ton of time. So here is the function, here is the, it's the same function that it rewrote from JavaScript, but this time it included that portion of the documentation at the top. It's going through every single one of the parameters. So it's even telling me that it's using the binary search algorithm. So it knows just looking at the code, notice that the code doesn't say that this is binary search. So just by looking at the code, ChatGPT recognizes this is binary search and is including that as part of the explanation here, which is great. Before we talk about the final two ideas, there's something I want you to keep in mind. I have 2+ decades of programming experience, and I like to think, at least I tell myself, that I know what I'm doing. I usually don't trust people's code, I don't trust my own code, and I surely don't trust ChatGPT's outputs. This is not about letting ChatGPT do my job. This is about using it to improve my productivity. ChatGPT will make mistakes, and that's why I'm here, to supervise it. This is a tool that helps me. It doesn't replace me. Let's look at idea number 9. We can ask ChatGPT to help us track down a bug. Like, for example, here I'm pasting the same function that we've been talking about, but this time there is a bug in the function. So I'm gonna ask ChatGPT, find the bug in the following function. So in this case, ChatGPT is basically giving me an explanation of where it thinks the bug is, and hopefully it's gonna give me a new piece of code without that bug. But let's see, it's writing the code right now. All right, so you can see right there, it fixed the code. The bug was right here. You notice that I removed the -1 from that line. ChatGPT correctly recognizes that that is what's going on here, and it's giving me an updated piece of code, but this time without the bug. You can use this functionality to find out what's happening, or at least to give you ideas so you can just go and keep tracking down that bug. 10th way you can use ChatGPTs for scaffolding, which is probably the one that I use the most. For example, here I'm gonna say, I want to upload a file to an S3 bucket, write a Python function that receives the file name as a parameter and the bucket name. The file is stored in the hard drive and it's a text file. Let's see what ChatGPT is gonna do with this. All right, so it's importing the Boto3 library, which is correct. That's exactly what you need to do in order to upload something. And it's basically getting the S3 resource, and now it's going to open the file. It did what I asked it to, which is hey, use the file name and the bucket name, pass it as arguments to that function. And here you can see how it's doing a put object. And then it's gonna write an explanation on how it did that. This is a great, great way to get started with something you want to do that you don't necessarily know how to approach it, and ChatGPT is gonna tell you how to get started with that. You can also obviously go to Stack Overflow, you can also go to, you know, read the documentation of that library, but I find that ChatGPT does a great job at this. By the way, there are many other use cases you can use ChatGPT for. There's one thing for you to remember. The story is not about ChatGPT taking programmers' jobs. It's not about one missing import here or a mistake over there. The story is how this tool can give you a huge boost overnight.